Nuttyitonline.com/livewire.
And joining us right now is a lady who I know about but don't really know yet.
Yes.
It is Maya. What is your last name?
DiGiorgio.
DiGiorgio.
Yes.
Maya DiGiorgio. Wow.
Now, Maya, you are a comedian and
yes, I am.
Actor or performer.
Yes.
And you're in town. Are you doing a play?
Yeah, I'm doing a one-person show, and Rain Pryor is the director.
Yeah, Rain's a good friend of the show.
Yeah, she speaks of you quite highly.
I love Rain. Yeah. So how long is your play running?
I'm running just this is my last weekend before I take off. So
oh,
I'm
cool.
going to be over at the Strand. It's a show about why I love is it worth it? It presents a history of
your life?
Characters. No, characters that tell you why love stinks and you shouldn't even be bothering.
I love it. I love that idea.
And what's it
bitter,
worth?
Bitter, table of one.
Yes.
Bitter,
yes.
Table of one.
Yeah, bitter. Yeah.
However, it's built on modernized Shakespeare's. So it's like Shakespeare for morons, pretty much.
Oh, please tell me everybody dies at the end.
Yeah, pretty much everybody dies at the end.
Every character gets killed.
Absolutely. And the script was actually punched up by Baltimore's Mark Voice when I was in Los Angeles.
No.
So I have quite bizarre lines in there. I was stuck with the Shakespeare line where I was like, it's too Shakespeare. It's never going to work. And he said, well, what's the line? I said, well, it's if
let me
rose
see if I can guess what he said.
Okay,
go ahead.
Okay, it's from Romeo and Juliet.
Right.
So it says, the line was originally, a rose by any other would smell just as sweet.
Right.
Right? So
yeah. That guy gave me a rose that stinks.
It was if a chicken was called Odor Eater, it would still taste good.
he's out of his mind.
He's got to be one of the most bizarre thinkers.
Yes.
But he's what led me to you.
Yeah. Well, Mark and I mean,
they've known each other for years. Yeah.
God.
And Mark was a regular on the morning show that was here before us.
Oh,
so,
okay.
And he would come up all the time. This is before he moved to L.A. Great guy.
Yeah, to become a professional barista.
Barista and extra.
Wait. He's doing okay. We did.
I love Mark.
We actually took him to Tony Woods.
Of course, genius.
So Tony, I was doing a comedy tour over in Scotland.
Yeah, and Mark went.
Yeah, and so he's like, it's called Hollywood Outlaw.
is my
brand. So
yeah.
So he's like, you got this is the guy you want.
Yeah.
So I don't know anything about Mark, but I'm like, I'll get us to Scotland. So my friend gets us like first class tickets. But he's got to be in a suit because they're buddy passes.
Okay? Oh, my God.
So this guy comes off the airplane, looks like he exploded while he was still in the suit. Do you know what I mean? He's like, I found a suit in the closet. I had a roommate that moved out. So I had the suit on, and his eyebrows. He doesn't even have eyebrows.
No.
He's got like feelers.
It's
so
like,
yeah. So I don't even know him. But as a girl, I'm like, as soon as the first 2 hours, I was like, can I trim your eyebrows before we go on stage? And
yeah, guys that are like that though are really touchy because my boyfriend gets a couple of those and I'm like, hey, can we help you
Mark.
Out with that?
Yeah, but
he's like, no, this is me.
Yeah,
no, these are so bad.
Mark, they're this long.
Yeah, they drag.
Pokes him in the eye.
They can get caught in things. You know, for his own safety and for the safety of the audience. I had him remove them. But then we did those shows for Hollywood Outlaw. He was doing radio and internet TV. And now we just launched Google Television with about 20, 30 Mark Voice shows on it. For
awesome.
You can get it if you get the...
That's better than the Barextra that he's trying to be.
Because you can't pull him away from that. You know, once he gets caught in a niche,
he's stuck forever.
He won't leave.
Yeah.
So with your show
I had a part-time job for 27 years. Yeah. I mean.
So what's the name of your show?
The show is called You Probably Think This Play Is About You.
You're so vain.
Very good.
Yeah, exactly.
And,
I love it.
You're touring the country with this?
Yes. Well, actually, this was the first city we've picked up, like I said, with Rain. So now I'm looking to probably bring it to D.C. and then over to Chicago.
Well, you're in great hands because Rain is the freaking best. And she just texted me, by the way. She's so excited.
Where where can people see this?
You can go down to the Strand Theater. It's actually, and we got a lot of great, it's actually pretty, it's very funny. We got a great review. We got a 4.5
awesome.
Star on, and they came into the dress rehearsal.
Wow.
So, yeah, and what a slob I was then. But, there's one character that likes to drink a lot, so they bought all these minis. So the dress rehearsal, we were like, oh,
just
drink
away.
Them all. Yeah, the whole crew. It was like, it was a blast.
Now, is L.A. home?
No, New York is home
New
for
York
me.
Is home for
yeah.
you. Awesome.
Yeah. I moved out to Los Angeles and crawled back. Cause
it's miserable.
It's the worst.
It sucks.
It's the worst.
The only thing that's great is waking up and it's 73 degrees every day.
That is absolutely it. The people.
Past that, I swear, if that whole city...